Hi friends, welcome back to React.js 0 to Hero series. This series is for beginners who wants to learn React.js from scratch. In the last video, I have explained about how to communicate between components through props. Also, I have explained about props drilling. In this video, I am going to explain about useContext hook and how we can use that to avoid props drilling. Let's start. I have created a new React application, in which I have created these components to explain about props drilling clearly. I have a parent component, that is what I have configured in the app component. And in this parent component, I have two child components, child 1 component and child 2 component. In child 1 component, I have grandchild 1 component, and in child 2 component, I have grandchild 2 component. I have a button in this grandchild 1 component. When it is clicked, I am changing a message in the grandchild 2 component. So to achieve this communication, I am updating the state in the parent component through callback function, which is passed through props. And then I am passing this state to grandchild 2 component through child 2 component using props. This is props drilling. You can see, even though the child 2 component is not using this props, we need to pass it through this component. We can avoid this using context. React context is a way to manage state globally. The React context provides data to components no matter how deep they are in the components tree. To use context in React, we need to follow three steps. We need to create the context, and then we need to provide the context, and finally we need to consume the context. Okay, let's implement context in our application. Let me create a new file for context so that we can reuse throughout our application. Okay, first step is to create the context. For that, we can use the built-in function createContext. Let me import that first. And then let me create the context. This is going to give us the context. And let me export this so that we can use it in our application. And the next step is that we need to provide this. For that, let me go to the app component and wrap this parent component with the provider from the context we created. First, we need to import the context here and then wrap this component like this. We can pass the value which we need to share. And the final step is to consume the context. For that, we can make use of useContext hook. I need to use the value in the grandchild 2 component. So let me first import the context and also useContext in this component. And now I can get the value from the context by passing the context into useContext. Let me display this here. And so we can see this value in this component. Okay, let me create another component. And let me add this component in app component inside this context provider. Now we can see we are able to get the value here also. If this component is outside the provider, we cannot access this value in this component. But in the same time, as grandchild 2 component is one of the descendant of this parent component, we are able to access this value there. And so usually we provide the context in the topmost level. So instead of providing here, let's provide in the index.js like this. Now we are able to get the value in all the components. This is how we can share a value globally. Hope you understood how context works. Let's see how we can use this to solve our props drilling problem. First, let's create a custom provider in our context. This is going to accept a props and return the provider from the context. Inside this, we can have props.children. We need to export this custom provider so that we can use this throughout our application. And in index.js, let me remove this provider and use our custom provider. And so whatever we pass here as children will be wrapped by our context provider. Earlier we hardcoded the value here, but now we have the option to pass our value here. Let me move the state we are maintaining in parent component to here. And pass the same to the value. And so we can access this state throughout our application. Now let me go to the grandchild 1 component. Here we don't need the props and this event handler function. Instead, let me get the state from the context and let me directly update the state in context using this function. Like this. And in grandchild2 component, I can get the state from the context. And instead of using the one in props, I can use this state. Here also, I don't need the props anymore. Even in the intermediate components also, let me remove the props and the unwanted functions. Now let me test. We can see it is working without props drilling. This is how we can use useContext to maintain the state throughout the application. Hope you understood. Let me give you a task. You can create this application where you can have a header component, a main component, and few children components. When you click these buttons here, the cart should be updated. You can try to develop this using useContext. Try this. If you need the solution code, you can get it from this repo. The link is also available in the description. That's all for today. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel, and support me. Thank you. Bye.